last year, I wore my first bikini. Sorry, was I supposed to clap? Sorry. My name's Alisi. I am 27 years old. I was born in Auckland, New Zealand, and I moved to Australia in 2001. I come from a large Tongan family, so I'm 3 out of 6 siblings, but I was actually the only one adopted out to my auntie and uncle, who I call my mum and dad. They pretty much raised me. I went to a high school where there was only a couple of us who were Polynesian. I felt kind of like an outcast. I had quite thick hair, so I wanted the straight hair. And I was quite voluptuous, I was quite curvy compared to the other girls. So I wanted to have that look. Definitely struggled with confidence. Going to the beach, I always wore shirts and t-shirt. I didn't want to wear a swimsuit, like just even a one piece, let alone a bikini. I couldn't do it. I wanted to, but I would compare myself to the other girls out there, even just with my hair, it being so thick, where I just wanted it straight. So I would spend hours in front of the mirror straightening my hair. I never was really true to myself. I would say in high school, I've always wanted to be a flight attendant, and once I got the job, I remember the phone call and I cried. And I remember the lady saying, "Are you okay? Did I say anything wrong?" I said, "No, it's tears of joy. This is what I always wanted to do." Have you seen the saying where it goes, find a career that actually doesn't feel like you're going to work? I was literally living that. Like being a flight attendant and knowing that no day was the same. Every day was a different day. Meeting different people from all walks of life. I did not realize how beautiful this country is, seriously, with the places that we got to go to. It's like there's so many hidden gems. I've never been to Darwin, and I went to Darwin, and I loved Darwin. Meeting the people out there were beautiful. It really opened my eyes up to a whole new world. At 24, I was diagnosed with stage 3 ovarian cancer at the end of 2017. I had the symptoms, but at being so young, all you want to think about is going out with your friends or going out clubbing or just, that's the last thing you think of is your health, really. At the end of 2017, I underwent a 8-hour operation, which left me in hospital for about a month. So I had a full hysterectomy, which means that unfortunately I cannot conceive my own children. And also half of my large bowel has been removed. That has caused complications even till now. Throughout 2018, I underwent 6 rounds of chemotherapy. I absolutely hated it, did not like it whatsoever. It was tough, became so vulnerable, definitely lost my confidence because I would see my friends living their life and they're moving forward and I'm just here at a standstill. I can't do anything. So going through chemo, it's something that I wish I didn't have to do, but for me to survive and to see another day, I had to do it. There was no choice. Once I finished my chemotherapy, I actually became quite depressed because I could not go back to being a flight attendant, which completely shattered me. My confidence went out the window. Just when I thought I had, you know, everything was going for me, my confidence was, I was so self-confident, I had it all, but because I had lost my hair, I would look at myself and I wouldn't see that. What people would say, "Oh, you still look beautiful." I did not see that. I just saw cancer. I don't feel beautiful. Towards the end of 2018, I picked myself back up and thought, hey, I gotta keep moving. I gotta keep going, I gotta keep living. My light bulb moment happened when I was in hospital, my first diagnosis, and I said to my family, I said, "You know what? I have cancer for a reason. This has given me a reason. Like, I feel like my purpose is to share my story with girls out there, with women out there that, hey, if it can happen to me, I'm not saying it can happen, but it can happen to anyone, and cancer doesn't discriminate." So it's really given me this different drive in life. With the experience with CGM and how I came about it, I saw it on Instagram and I was just reading through it and I thought, oh, why not I just try this modeling and confidence campaign? It was not what I was expected, as in, it was so empowering. Just just to be in a room full of girls with, it was all different ages. Like, I felt like I was probably one of the oldest there, but there was also, I met a couple of girls who were the same age as me. Everyone comes in different shapes and sizes and comes, you know, we're all from different backgrounds. So it was really nice to be in a room where you can just be you, but also hearing their stories and why they are there. There was always something that I could relate to. I felt like I belonged here. Like, yes, this is where I need to be. This is it. So when I did my photo shoot, oh, even just doing it, it was amazing. Like, the photographer was great. Even the girls in the background were like, you can do it, you look so good. And just hearing all that positivity, it really gets you in the mood. Like, oh, I can do this. Like, I feel like I'm Naomi Campbell. But when I actually saw the photos, I had a moment. It just gave me that boost. Like, wow, this is how I look. But I didn't see that within myself. For me personally, it took me to have this photo shoot that I thought wouldn't have turned out that great. There I go again, self-doubt. In 2019, last year, I wore my first bikini. Sorry, was I supposed to clap? Sorry. Not only I wore it in public, I walked around in my bikini. And that was a big step for me. I never thought I could wear a bikini because I did not look like, you know, what you see on social media, or like, I was just me in my own head thinking, oh, I need to have this certain look. But no, went to the beach and just wore it. And tell you what, that was a moment for me to wear my first bikini at the age of 26, but that's okay. I finally got to wear a bikini and feel comfortable within my own skin and also show off my scars, because I've got quite a large scar. So yeah, that was a moment for me. 2020, I decided to step out of my shell and challenge myself and decided to do a diploma business because I had to look for a different career path. Just when I thought everything was coming back to normal, in March I found out that the cancer had come back. So here I was, felt like I was back at square one. Yeah, which affected my confidence again. And every time when I see my photos from the photo shoot with CGM, that's my reminder. Like, remember who you are. I have not deferred my study, so I'm still completing my diploma of business. I really want to get into human resources. Love helping people. I want to help people. Doing CGM, modeling did cross my mind, but I thought, nah, I can't be a model. I feel like I don't have that thought. You know, you can do it. You just have to try. For one of my goals is to be an ambassador, but also to, I don't know, do modeling. Just to show a different side to beauty. You may feel different, but just to show people that you can have cancer and you can still be a model. You can have an illness, but don't let that affect you. You can still be what you want to be. This is one of my goals, is to be an ambassador for young women who have ovarian cancer. So what makes me a warrior is the challenges that are set in life, and being able to conquer them is what makes me a warrior. Having to face cancer head on and still coming up on the other end is what makes me a warrior. But just waking up to a new day and looking in the mirror and thinking, damn, I look good, damn, I feel good, it is what makes me a warrior. Waking up to a new day and getting through that day, no matter how bad it is or even how great it was, is what makes me a warrior. My advice to my younger self would be that despite what the challenges that you are facing, that you could be facing now, everyone may seem they're moving ahead of you, but they're not. They're moving to their pace or their clock, because it's just your journey is different and everyone's journey is different. So your time will come and you will overcome that challenge. So always remember, it's just a setback, but there is a greater comeback.